You can always taste when something is just missing that one element that you don't know what it is, that it's missing something from the heart. It's missing something from the soul. So if you think that you have something great, just make sure you put your heart and soul into it and do whatever you need to do that.
We like to keep it interesting, so we do change the flavors around quite a bit, just so people can kind of come to the store every day if they wanted to and get something different.
My parents weren't thrilled that I wanted to go into the food industry. I think my dad was the one that said, what are you gonna do with it? But by then, I think I had grown the courage to say, you know what, this is just what I'm gonna do. I didn't give him any reasons, but I still needed to finish my degree, which I did. Eventually, after that, I went to culinary school. That's a big thing in the Chinese culture, to stand up to your parents, yeah.
Jenny and I met at culinary school.
He had fancy shoes on in the kitchen, which I thought was odd. We were always broken into smaller groups, and the one time that I was in a group with Alex, I hated working with him. I thought he was just messy or just rude.
She has a lot of OCD, and I at the time I didn't, so it was kind of like always, you know, like butting heads.
It wasn't until afterwards, towards the end of culinary school, that we started dating, and for whatever reason, we really got along and we realized that we complemented each other.
We had a day where we made ice cream and sorbet. This is delicious. And then I asked them, can I come in the morning? And I would make my own stuff, whatever it was, whatever. At that time, I was like, making crazy stuff. Guinness, like when people weren't making Guinness, I was making Guinness, like all that, and all these like weird flavors. And most of them sucked because I didn't know what I was doing. But I didn't actually think to do it. I don't, no clue, no idea about it. I thought if I was going to culinary school, I wanted to work at a really high-end place. Finished culinary school, I worked in restaurants. When I worked at Laboratorio, you kind of start off at the bottom doing tedious things like peeling pears or washing dishes, but you should accept those and accept being good at them. You go backwards, like you can't make sorbet until you've processed the fruit. When you've peeled maybe like 500 pears, then you can start making the sorbet. And then that's how you go, and then you go each step until you get to the top. And you kind of know when you get to the top. Where you know you've mastered as much as you could where you are. That's one of the reasons why I left where I worked in New York, is because like, there's nothing left for me here.
He brings this creativity side to him, this uniqueness that I haven't seen in anybody else. We fill in the blanks together.
Jenny is actually like the anchor, because sometimes I'm very like theoretical, or I kind of drift off to like ideas. Jenny's the one that kind of keeps it grounded. And I think our personalities shine through when you're at the store, whether it's like the flavors, the quotes we put up, it's just like how it feels.
Well, they're in my home, so I want to make sure everybody feels comfortable in my home.
or my house in Passaic. Most people are immigrants from anywhere, like all over the place, and it's always transition. Back in the day, it was like a Czechs and Poles, got like all different people from Latin America, people from Africa now, like parts of the Middle East. Growing up, we always had this garden in the back. I mean, it's the Garden State. That's like, everybody should have a garden as far as I'm concerned, unless you live in Jersey City. We plant mint like underneath the tomato and the bean plants just because they grow wild, and we use plenty of it at the store, so just keep planting it and using it. I bought this fig plant from my parents, and it's actually been pretty successful. And it does produce fruit. You know, we'll use it to make sorbet. And then if not, then we use the leaves to make like fig leaf ice cream, which is actually very, very good. It has like almost a coconut milky flavor.
We weren't sure how our store was going to be received. We weren't sure how our ice cream was going to be received, because I know there's quite a bit of other ice cream frozen desserts nearby. We were also uncertain whether how people would receive different flavors every day, every week. And I think at the end of the day, Alex says, you know, you just have to make what feels right to you. You have to push what you believe is right. We just kind of went with it, and we were pleasantly surprised with how open our customers are. And that actually drove us to do more. It pushed us because they appreciate it with open arms. And all we can do to repay them is really to kind of push ourselves even farther.
Last summer was like thing, I had like a line up to 10 o'clock. People just like scooping like crazy, and people were having fun, the music was louder. But now it's like, it was, when we opened up, it's like we have plexiglass. The music can't be as loud because there's plexiglass. Everybody's wearing a mask, so you can't understand them anyway. But my mind, like after a day thinking about it, was like, just get in there and make it as good as you can and try to do as best you can for our customers. The coronavirus kind of made me kick it into like another gear where kind of have more fun with like what we make, because there's plenty of stuff I made this year that I never even made last year, but trying to keep you a little entertained.
Just seeing people come in and seeing their faces light up, and when they say, you know, I've never been a chocolate fan, and they love it. They love our chocolate. That really excites me. It really tells me that, hey, we're doing something right.
We're lucky right now that we're actually doing like pretty well when we're busy. But it could have gone the other way easily to me. So we kind of just like went with it. And if we fail, we fail. But to me, that's the most basic thing, is if you're going to fail, you might as well like do something good while you do it.
Success means that we've changed kind of the way people see frozen desserts. I think people can require a higher quality, more creativity. That to me means like, yeah, we've changed somebody's ideas and ideals of ice cream.